Good morning and welcome to Hot Points from London. I'm Sam Lightning. Today is 23rd, Wednesday of April. And we have 2 weeks left until the general election. And for the next two shows after this one, that is what we're going to be talking about. First of all, today we are focusing on public opinions of what different parties are thinking and what the public thinks of different parties. First of all, guys, I want to talk about the previous government. I want to talk about what, since the Conservatives took over in 2010, what do you think has been done? Do you think it's a good thing? And do you think it's a reason for them to get voted in? First of all, let's focus on what's been done. The deficit has been halved. How does everyone feel about that? It's a good idea, even though the Labour Party have chosen to freeze the actual asset and freeze the taxation in some places temporarily. Right? Would you trust the Labour Party again after the deficit, or would you focus on the Conservatives' so-called long-term economic plan, which at this point isn't failing? What do you think?
I mean, so far it seems to be working. I mean, they have, you know, kept the word in certain areas, but they are just very cruel. I'm not sure. I'm in the middle here. What about you?
No, I would agree. Took the words right out of my mouth. It's just kind of stuck in the middle. You kind of don't know who is with you. Every political party seems to be focusing on one thing specifically. It's just that one thing that they seem to be working on. Mainly, hello,
we're
on the camera.
Steve, give me a minute.
Go ahead.
I'm just being told now, I gotta mention, I completely did forgot.
With what?
Yes, our three episode session on the general election. This is based on public opinion, so no formal experience or research has gone into this episode. This is just what the public is thinking at the moment. Next show will be our official debrief of what we think is gonna happen, and the show after that will be the actual general election date of what happened, how it happened, in which place, and what was surprising, what took place that we didn't see coming, and what took place that we did see coming. So please stay tuned for that one. Now I want to talk about the Labour Party. They've obviously been very busy, and after they got voted out, Ed Miliband got pushed into the head of the Labour Party, and he has promised that taxes will be lower, although there is no place this money could be coming from. If the Labour Party had to choose, where do you think they'd take the money from?
I'll be honest, I think they'll raise VAT again. They'll find some way of taking the money back. It's a classic example of taking from one hand, giving from the other.
Because it's not just the Labour Party, is it, that's promising money that isn't there? It's also the Conservative Party.
It's every party.
It's the Lib Dems, it's pretty much everyone. They're just promising money that variably isn't there.
Yep, true.
So they've got to get that out of somewhere. I mean, what are you thinking? Where are they going to get this money out of? I mean, David Cameron said that he was going to cut down benefits, but is it really enough?
Yeah, well, of course we know that where Labour's going to get their money from, like from taxes and, of course, the mansion tax that they said that they're, you know, going to impose if they get into power. And I think the Conservatives at this point, like people, it's like, from what I'm hearing, it's like the Conservatives, I think they're just, you know, people think that they're a bit desperate now because they feel as if they're, you know, they're behind, you know, the Labour Party. So they just, you know, came out with £8 billion. You know, saying
you,
that they're
you
gonna,
say
like,
you
they're
say
gonna
they feel
it.
As if they're behind no, like, you know, polls, the Labour Party, polls. But what are you thinking? Are they really? Do you have anything to push that back forward? Or?
No, not really. It's just, you know, from what I've been hearing around, you know, because since people don't know where they're going to get their money from, which I believe they're going to have something, you know, very similar to the Labour Party. So it's going to be more or less like, you know, Tory and Tory light, right? So that's the kind of thing that, you know, I see as happening. You know, it's not really going to be much of a
difference.
Okay,
we obviously have a lot of things coming our way over the next 2 weeks. We have different facts we're going to be thrown with every day, emails that we're going to be thrown with every day, and we'll inform our viewers as soon as we get those through, and any research that we get them through in next episode. But this episode, I just want to focus on the Lib Dems, mainly, for the next 5 minutes. So let's focus on the Lib Dems. The coalition.
It failed.
Two-party government. You say it failed. You say it failed. Right?
It failed.
But you have to explain that. How did it? Why did it? Why do you think it failed?
They promise so much. It's like when you enter a new relationship, you promise all these things. You promise a new baby. You promise happiness, but nothing happens.
Let's not talk into family relationships. Let's focus on government for a second.
It's a relationship Coalition is a relationship between two government parties.
It is, so yes, but...
It's a similar thing. But they promise so much, and they just
like,
let
what are we
everyone
talking about?
Down.
Voting reform?
Voting reform...
But voting reform was never going to come about. That was, the Conservative Party clearly said that voting reform wasn't going to take place at the beginning of that coalition.
Well, same... They said they was thinking of exiting the EU as well, but that didn't happen.
Who did?
Lib Dems.
The Lib Dems... said they were thinking of exiting.
Yeah, thinking, but
not didn't promise.
Thinking is, they is basically promising.
It's not promising, in guys. Come on, feel free to jump in anytime.
Because it gains you votes.
Think is
He's
thinking like promising.
Oh,
is thinking like he promising. If I say I think this is going to happen, am I promising that it's going to happen?
It's basically.
You'll feel free to promise all that you want. What matters is that once you're elected, are you going to continue to fulfill those promises? This thing happens in America all the time, where governments make such a big deal out of being voted for. They want to get voted by the people. It happens a lot, so often that you think that we might learn something from it. You think that we might understand. It just doesn't happen.
Oh, wow. They put their credibility on the line, and so far nobody really trusts politicians, which is something we should talk about.
Yeah.
But
which FYI is the case I will be standing for in next week's episode of Hot Points. Don't miss it.
The defender of
the
people.
Yes, the revolutionary. Yeah, absolutely.
I will be
revolution
this
will be
I will be next episode's Russell Brand.
Okay. So we got the revolutionary. Me, I'm gonna focus on the Tories. What about you, Hussein?
What party?
Honestly, Tory, Labour, Green, Lib Dems, or
I'm having
UK.
A hard time so far. I mean, so for students, it seems Labour at least, you know, is looking at, for example, they said in their policies that they would lower £6,000, which is, you know, do you think they would? Like, would
no.
That seems unlikely.
Because where would they get the money?
Exactly. They can't.
It's already 9,000.
Maybe not 6,000. Maybe 7,000, 8,000, but it can't be 6,000.
That's
way
too... how much money they owe us in the first place.
Oh, yeah.
To be quite honest with you, I feel like the whole two-party government thing has worked. Like, if we went back to a one-party government, it feels like we're going backwards on ourselves, does it not?
When you say what, explain what you mean, though. In what way?
Well, here's the thing about government, I feel. When a party gets into power, and they have every single bit of power and rulemaking, what they tend to do is put their own values, focus on their own values and ideals, and some values from other parties are there because other people, the population, want a part of that. But those values don't get heard because it's only one party. Whereas if there's two parties, there's always a blue team and a red team.
Yeah.
There's always an opposing force. There's always something to filter out all the good stuff and take out all the bad stuff.
Yeah.
So in that way, I think the coalition has definitely worked to the point where, you know, we're considering our choices.
Mm.
So would you consider a SNP and Labour coalition for the next election? Do you think that could happen?
I don't think SNP hold the best values here.
Well, I don't think they don't, but Nicola Sturgeon, I think it is. She did offer Edmund Van a chance for that.
No, she did, and
very publicly,
there, it has been rumored that this is happening. But again,
the
we
question
can't...
is, was Ed done with that chance? Has he used it to its fullest, or
cut
has
back.
He just?
Yeah. Listen, I think Lib Dems need to be in there, whether it's Labour or Conservative. I think Lib Dems definitely need to be in a coalition there.
No, I think the SNP, I think Ed Miliband should take up the opportunity to actually make a coalition with the SNP. Because when you look at it, right, the SNP got the whole of Scotland, you know, right behind them. You know, when you have a look at it, it's like, I think around 95% of the Scottish population are actually backing the SNP. So when you think about it...
Are you sure about that?
Oh, yeah, I've actually seen the map this morning.
I think
yeah,
it's
like maybe there are, you know, there are bits
Scotland
of red in there.
Scotland would back someone up in the first place. The only thing that Scotland wants is independence. You can easily just promise Scotland independence
exactly.
And just do exactly what you want anyway.
Yeah, but that's the thing, because you see, it's like the Tories, they were saying that if we actually bring in the SNP, like in a coalition with, you know, the Labour Party, it's just going to, you know, create, you know, a disastrous kind of situation for the UK. Maybe even, you know, acts of, you know, I don't know, independence or something like that for Scotland. Maybe there could be a second type of referendum by, I don't know, 2020. They were talking about that.
A second referendum by 2020 seems a bit far-fetched, to be honest.
Yeah.
You know what, guys? I think that is all we have time for in today's show. Let's end early. Please join us for next week's show when we will be discussing the possibilities of what could happen this general election. From London, I'm Sam Lightning. Thank you for watching.